So you want to filter internal traffic from your GA4 reports? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how you do that. Let's dive in. Welcome to the channel. My name is Leon. This channel exists to help you make better decisions in your daily work with your analytics data. If you like what I'm doing, please click like and subscribe. That really helps me get this channel off the ground. Also, if you're interested in similar videos on how to set up GA4, there's a link in the video description with an entire playlist full of videos just like this. All right, before we start, let's first discuss why would you enable internal traffic filters in your reports? Well, traditionally, it has been a best practice to just enable it on every site that's using Google Analytics, to just enable internal traffic filters. Because if you're looking at a report that contains, let's say, 100 users, and you're not sure if those users are really your target audience, or just you and your colleagues just browsing around to your site, that's really annoying. And it's really helpful to know when looking at the reports that the data that you're looking at is not just you or your colleagues polluting the data, but it's really your target audience. That's why it's kind of best practice to just enable it on every GA4 property. And I say kind of best practice because filtering out everyone in your organization has become a little bit difficult. Because more and more people are working from home nowadays and getting everyone's IP address is just not realistic anymore. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you set up internal traffic filters in your GA4 reports. But I recommend to filter out only the people on your site that are really polluting the data. So let's say you or some of your colleagues are testing out conversions quite regularly. Well, if you have 10 conversions in your reports that are really test conversions, that's really annoying. So let's say you have a web shop and you regularly test the whole funnel just to check if everything's working. I recommend you filter out all those IP addresses. Also, if you have a very low traffic site, so for example, your site is aimed at other businesses, like business to business organizations usually have lower traffic on their site. So if that's the case, I recommend that you filter out as many of the colleagues that regularly browse on your site just to filter out any pollution that might exist. Because let's be honest, if your site has tens of thousands of users and a couple of hundred people visit the site that are from your organization, you won't really notice that. But if your site only has 100 users and 50 of those users are your colleagues, that's really annoying. So that's when you should enable internal traffic filters for sure. So let's go into GA4 and I'll show you in just 3 steps how you set up internal traffic filters. The first step really is some investigation. I like to set up a spreadsheet with IP addresses. And then in the first column, I'll just put in a name. And in the second column, I put the IP address. And then I just go around my colleagues asking them what their IP address is. And really what they should do is just go into Google and type in, what's my IP address? There you go. And everyone should do this in the location that they're frequently visiting. So I also have an office. If I want to set up internal traffic filters for my site, I would have 2 locations, my home location, which is this IP address, and then my IP address for the office. And you do this for everyone that's frequently using the site, either by testing conversions or just visiting in general. So you fill out everyone's home or office IP address, and it really helps to not just get IP addresses, but also take note of what that IP address represents, because it will save you a lot of work down the line when you want to maintain this GA4 property. First step is done. Let's say you have your document full of IP addresses that you want to filter. The second step is going into admin and then into data streams. You just go ahead and click on your site. And then when you have opened your data stream, we're going to click a few more times. You need to go down into configure text settings. Then you will see a screen like this. In this screen, you have a button on the right that says show all, because by default, the internal traffic filters are hidden. So when you click on show all, there's a button here that says define internal traffic. If you click that, now we're in the screen where we can define what our internal traffic is. So for instance, I click create and I say Leon's home IP address equals, and then I just fill out my IP address and I say create. And I do this for every IP address that's on the list. You can add 10 rules in this screen. So if you want to add more IP addresses, I recommend that you just do it like this. So let's say Leon's home and Leon's office, I want to combine that. I just say Leon and in brackets, I say home office. And then I just add a new condition and say IP address equals, and I add my second IP address in here as well. This saves you a few slots. So if you've defined all your IP addresses here, the second step is already done. Let's go ahead into the third step, which is actually filtering out the IP addresses that we've defined here. So we go back and then we're still under admin. Let's check if you're on the right side. And then in the middle column under data settings, there's a section that says data filters. Here we already have an internal traffic filter set up, but it's currently in testing mode, which means that traffic comes in, it gets tagged as internal traffic so we can test if it's working. This is actually a step that I skipped when setting up GA4 because literally in my entire career, this has not gone wrong a single time. But if you have a site where the stakes are really high and really want to know, does it work? You could leave it on testing. You need to do that for a couple of days. The documentation of GA4 states that it takes 24 to 36 hours before the filter really starts working. If you want to test if it's working, you can go into your reports and just open up, for instance, your traffic acquisition report. And then you can go into comparison and say test data filter name. And then there's an internal traffic option. So if you enable that, it will show you how many filtered traffic you have in your reports. So if you wait for a couple of days, you'll see what the impact of that filter is. The data is not filtered yet, but you can check if your filter is working properly. The third step is actually enabling the filter. So I'm going back into admin, into data settings, data filters. And now if I go into the internal traffic filter, I can actually enable this filter by setting filter state to active. And then if I hit save and I can say activate filter, this is how you set up internal traffic filters in GA4. Well, before I close off, let me go over a couple of important things that you need to know if you've set it up. First of all, filtered traffic doesn't show up in your report. It goes into the trash. You will never see it again. In previous versions of Google Analytics, Google would enable you to set up some backup in case there was something wrong with your filters. In GA4, that's not possible. So setting up filters really is destructive for the filtered data. So you should be careful. If you see something odd in your data, try disabling your filter or maybe setting it up in test modus to investigate if there's a problem with your filters. Secondly, if you try to test your GA4 setup with the debug view, so the debug view is here, by the way, under admin and then debug view. So if you try to test your site in this debug view and your internal traffic filters are enabled and you're filtering out your actual location, your debug view will not work. So you should maybe enable your mobile hotspot or temporarily disable your filter to actually test your GA4 setup. But bear in mind that your debug view will not work if internal traffic filters are enabled. Thirdly, if you are in a very large organization, often there's a way to work around individual IP addresses. So I've come across quite a few larger organizations that require every member of the organization to log in via some VPN or remote access. If that's the case with you, like where everyone is logging in to the environment that's on site, chances are that the entire organization, even though the people are working from home, that the entire organization is actually visiting your site from an internal network, which means that there's probably some kind of IP range that you can filter out all at once. So if you're in a very large organization, you could talk to the IT department to ask if there's some kind of IP range that you could use to filter out all of the internal traffic all at once. All right, that's it. That's how you filter internal traffic from your GA4 property. If you liked the video, please leave a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. That really helps me get this channel off the ground. I hope this video was clear. I hope it was helpful. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments below. Also, if you want to see more videos on how to set up GA4 properties, there's a link in the description to an entire playlist full of videos just like this. All right, thank you a lot for watching this video. I hope you have a great day. I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.